Welcome to a new Planetary and Seismic update. We look at magnitude 5.5 at large earthquakes in the previous time frame, from the 21st to the 30th. We see the typical clustering of stronger earthquakes on the 24th and on the 27th, 28th. And we also see seismic activity above average. If you look at the magnitude 6 earthquakes, we had 5 of them in a little over 6 days, definitely above average. Like I said in the previous update, we're probably going to see seismic activity above average because of the convergence, in particular, of lunar geometry. We also see the convergence of critical planetary geometry from the 28th to the 30th. We see the clustering there peaking 6.5 at the Scotia Sea. Some agencies reported 6.6, and that would have been the largest earthquake since early May. But so far, especially convergence on the 29th, 30th has not resulted in major seismic activity. If you look at the next time frame, we see some clustering on the 2nd, and that's in the mid-higher 5 magnitude range following the high lunar peak, the green peak. As I said in the previous update, we had lunar geometry converging here on the 2nd. If we count about 2.5 days from that lunar peak, there is still a possibility of larger seismic activity today. And that's also when Earth is going to align with Venus and Uranus. And that brings us to the next time frame. From the 1st to the 10th of July. We see Earth, Venus, Uranus today on the 4th. Like I said, it's about 2.5 days from that high lunar peak that follows on the critical geometry, the convergence on the 30th. And it is the sequence that counts. So there is still the potential for a major seismic event, also because of Earth, Venus, Uranus that happens today. So later today, tomorrow, there is the potential for larger seismic activity. We have right angle geometry converging also later on the 4th, early on the 5th with Mercury, Jupiter, Neptune and Venus, Mercury, Jupiter. And then we're going to have a pair of semi-right angle geometry with Mercury, Venus, Uranus, 45 degrees and Venus, Mercury, Uranus. That is on the 6th. 135 degrees. And then we see a lunar peak, Moon, Earth, Uranus coming up, converging with, almost converging with Moon, Earth, Venus. And that means that we could see increased seismic activity around the 8th. And interestingly, we see that Mars, Mercury, Saturn is converging there as well. And that is not going to be an exact conjunction. It is almost exact down to the seconds. And that's why we see this long red line for several days. And if we look at the solar system, this is because Mars, Mercury and Saturn are almost in a conjunction. It's because of the position in their orbits around the sun that this near conjunction lasts for several days. And it is going to converge with Sun, Venus, Saturn later on the 9th. And that's also when the moon will align with Jupiter. And that is a critical convergence, as you see here in the solar system. And as a result, we could see larger seismic activity around the 11th. It's also converging with the full moon on the 10th. So I say the 10th, 11th, maybe the 12th, there can be larger seismic activity because of the convergence of planetary and lunar geometry. So overall, we have some critical geometry coming up with Mercury and Venus and the high lunar peak Earth, the moon aligning with Uranus and also with Venus. So difficult to say exactly when the largest seismic activity is going to occur. This could very well be directly following the planetary geometry on the 4th and 5th. But we usually take into account the lunar peaks and we count about 2 days from the lunar geometry. This is the update for now. Check out the website and also the social media for the latest updates. Stay safe. Until next time.